Hi there, everyone, and thanks for clicking on Close Up. The comments may have been made on Facebook, but they were heard around the nation. House Majority Leader DJ Bettencourt joins us on the program this week to discuss his thought process when he called Bishop John McCormick a, quote, pedophile pimp after the bishop was critical of House budget cuts.
I took a bit of an exception to that because I know firsthand in being involved in the budget process that the Finance Committee did everything they possibly could to make sure that the necessary cuts that we had to make to our budget to ensure that state government lived within its means did not disproportionately hurt those who most rely on state services. So I took a bit of an exception to that.
Now, and last week you said you apologized, and you said that you apologized for the choice of words. Are you sorry for what you said, or are you sorry that you said it?
I'm sorry for the poor choice of words, Josh. You know,
have a belief. I mean, the undercurrent is still there.
Josh, I think all of us were deeply troubled. And you don't have to be a Catholic to be troubled by what took place.
Now, Representative Bettencourt also talks about those budget cuts and why he thinks they need to be as deep as they are. Also, from pension reform to collective bargaining amendments to right-to-work unions, well, they're feeling a little bruised up these days. We'll talk about it with Mark McKenzie of the AFL-CIO and Cornerstone Action's Kevin Smith.
What is the motivation for people who come in and say right to work is a good idea in New Hampshire? It's either an economic argument, and I think we could beat them hands down on an economic argument, or if it's a philosophical argument. Some opponents may be philosophically opposed.
Well, Josh, I would say that again, this comes back to personal freedom of choice here. It's about choice of whether or not you're going to be compelled to pay into the union. And Mark is right. You're not forced to join the union, but you are forced into paying agency fees that has been negotiated into the collective bargaining agreement, and I don't see it going away anytime soon. The fact of the matter is that you do have 22 states that are right to work. The closest one to New Hampshire is Virginia. And the other fact of the matter is that you have companies that simply don't want to deal in states that are not right to work.
Also, we'll have the latest action by potential presidential candidates and a poll that suggests that Donald Trump is being taken seriously by a lot more voters than originally thought. We'll see you Sunday at 10.